In case of J.C. Dugard is set to take center stage at a hearing today at the state capitol. At issue is how did the accused kidnapper and convicted rapist Phillip Garrido slip through the parole board cracks? KCRA3's Kevin Riggs is live with more.
Yeah, Walt, the head of California's correction system is testifying at this hour before a special Senate panel at issue shortcomings on how California manages its large sex offender population that's out on parole, and more specifically, what went wrong with the supervision of Phillip Garrido.
So a couple of key findings that, in the Garrido case that I think are particularly relevant here that I would like to discuss. One is regarding classification. The report notes that Garrido was improperly classified as a low-risk sex offender some 10 years ago or 11 years ago when he first came to California. And as you may know, we now assess every sex offender that leaves our prison system with a static 99 assessment to try to address that issue. Moreover, you know, we've gone back and looked to see, are there any offenders who came from other states or who have transferred, or any offenders who have not been assessed?
At the state level, there are roughly 9,000 registered sex offenders, just to give you an idea, and of course many more than that when you look at the county parole level. Again, Matthew Cate, the head of corrections, saying that they're working on improving training of parole agents. We've all heard the information about how certain clues were missed in the supervision of Phillip Garrido over the years, and Cate says they're working on that by trying to establish a field-level supervisor level to improve the training of existing agents as well as new agents. They're also was criticism today about the department's over-reliance on GPS technology, as, the state is probing what the corrections department can do better to deal with this problem and to guarantee more public safety when it comes to the issue of sex offenders that are out on parole. Live at the state capitol, Kevin Riggs, KCRA 3 reports.
Kevin, does this all go back to, in some cases, lack of funds available, fewer agents? Has that come up?
There was some discussion of that. Certainly resources are limited, and that was brought up by corrections, that the caseload is very large, and that as a result, in part, they have been relying heavily on GPS. But as critics have been noting, GPS is no replacement for good old-fashioned footwork, and so that's something else they're trying to deal with.
Yeah, good point. Kevin Riggs live at the state capitol.